Welcome to GYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics. And what we do, we daily cover two subtopics. And in this manner, in 6 days, all your 12 subtopics are covered. And this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner. So we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019 and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. So today is lecture number 57 and the lecture is of environment. So let's see what are the MCQs of today's lecture. The first question is, consider the following statements with reference to the plastic management rules 2016. First, jurisdiction of applicability of these rules extend to rural areas. Second, it introduces responsibility of waste generators such as households. Third, these rules mark the Union government's first attempt at addressing the issue of scientific plastic management, waste management. So we have to choose that which of the above statement is correct. So let me tell you friends that only first and second is correct. The third is not correct. Already in 2011, the Union government had made the attempt of addressing this issue of scientific plastic waste management. So the answer is 1 and 2 only. A is the answer. So solution is there. So here is explanation. You can see it. For the first time, the plastic waste management rules were notified in 2011, and some new provisions were added in 2016 rules. Like rural areas have been brought in the ambit of these rules, as the plastic has now reached the rural areas also, and the responsibility for implementation of these rules is given to Gram Panchayat as well as to the waste generators, for example, industries, individuals, bulk generators, and these commercial establishments. So what they have to do, they have to segregate the plastic waste at source and hand over the segregated waste and pay user fee as per bylaws of the local bodies. So this is the first question. Let's move on to the second question. The second question is, the Ken-Betwa river interlinking project involves deforesting a portion of A. Satpura Tiger Reserve, B. Panna Tiger Reserve, C. Indravati Tiger Reserve, D. Pench Tiger Reserve. Let me tell you friends that the answer is Panna Tiger Reserve. The Ken-Betwa river interlinking project is basically in UP and it also includes the area of Madhya Pradesh. So it aims to interlink these two rivers, but in the process there will be deforesting of the Panna Tiger Reserve approximately of its 10% area. So here in this question we have included only the solution, that is B. The in detail explanation is not provided because we provide explanation of only first question. So in case you want to subscribe to the explanation PDFs of all the questions, then you can email us at this email ID, that is gyes21@gmail.com, or you can contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So certainly there will be a certain cost for the explanation PDFs, but it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability and for the purpose of our motivation. Let's move on to the third question. Already we have covered your second question, and the third question is, Kyun variety pineapple is the state fruit of which state? A. Arunachal Pradesh, B. Tripura, C. Sikkim, D. Assam. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is Tripura. So it is a simple factual question. So there is no explanation to this question. Answer is Tripura. So solution is B. Let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, Cartagena Protocol and Nagoya Protocol are both related to A. Conservation of biological diversity, B. Paris Agreement, C. Convention on the Conservation of Natural Heritage, D. UN Convention to Combat Desertification. So we have to choose the correct answer, and let me tell you friends, answer is A, that is conservation on biological diversity. So basically Nagoya Protocol is related to your convention on these genetically modified benefits arising from your genetic resources. And this is related to conservation and biological diversity. So the answer is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, National Project on Aquifer Management first will enable characterization of the quantity, quality as well as sustainability of groundwater in aquifers. Second, envisages active participation of local communities in implementation of aquifer mapping project. Third is supported by Department for International Development of the Government of UK. So we have to choose the correct statements. Let me tell you, friends, that all of these statements are correct. So the answer is D. That is 1, 2 and 3. So this is the explanation. Answer is D. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following statements. First, worldwide about 29% of plastic produced gets recycled. Second, India has pledged to do away with single-use plastic by 2022. So we have to choose the correct statement. And friends, let me tell you that only one statement is correct, and that is second statement. So the answer would be B. That is second only. Let's move on to the next question. Consider the following pairs. That is UN initiative and decade of implementation. So we have to check that which of the following are correctly matched. First, water for life decade 1990 to 2000. Second, international drinking water supply and sanitation decade 2000 to 2010. And third is international decade for action on water for sustainable development 2010 to 2020. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer here is the answer is none of the above. So let's see what is the answer. So answer is none of the above. In case you want the explanation, you have to subscribe for explanation PDFs. So you can contact us at this email ID and this contact number. So let's move on to the next question. Next question is sacred grooves. First, are patches of forest that have been left untouched by local people and any interference with them is banned. Second, are found in only in Western Ghats. So we have to choose the correct answer. And let me tell you, friends, that only first statement is correct, and that is A, one only. So solution is A. Let's move on to the next question, the last question of the day. Today only we are covering 9 questions, otherwise we cover 10 questions really. So today's lecture only we are covering 9 questions. The MBAI is a project supported by European Space Agency and NASA that seeks to understand changes in Antarctic ice mass. B, an FAO report that for the first time presents a global analysis of trends in fish stocks. C, an intergovernmental effort by the Worldwide Fund for Nature to protect the vulnerable snow leopard. D, an European Union initiative that will monitor every active volcano on Earth from the space. So we have to choose the correct option, and the correct option is A. That is a project supported by European Space Agency and NASA that seeks to understand changes in Antarctic ice mass. So this is the answer. So this is all about friends today's lecture. If you like the video, if you like the questions, then do hit a like. Please ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and also do not forget to press the bell icon. Because then only you will get all the important notifications of the updates that we do on our channel. So in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs of explanation PDFs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveis21@gmail.com, and this contact number 89684264481. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day.